So far we talked about linear control, and linear control we know. We looked at voltage mode and current mode. In nonlinear, you have hysteretic constant on or off time. Okay. So I mean, they are usually interrelated, and there are some other methods also. Some people call it like V square control is another, but we will not talk about that. It is another hysteretic control. But everything is here actually ripple based. It is all ripple based. I mean, all three are ripple based. Control. Okay. So now let us say I have L and C. This is my output. In the feedback, if I have a comparator, and let us say this is hysteretic comparator with plus minus delta VH by 2. Okay, which means peak to peak is VH. If this is VREF plus minus, and this is your V out, and I have this is your gate driver. When I say gate driver, you can assume it has non-overlap clock and buffers everything in it. So I don't have to draw again and again same thing. And if I call it this VPWM, so what would happen here? This is nonlinear, it can have only two states. Okay, what are those two states? In linear control, that was a continuous voltage DC V control, but here that is not possible because this comparator gain is very high. So the moment it sees even a small difference between VREF and V out, it will just trip to VDD or ground. So if this is VDD and ground, let me write. And hysteresis window is plus minus delta VH by 2. Okay. VDD and ground. So, which means you are directly getting the clock here instead of taking the V control comparing with the RAM. So what is the benefit of this? Can anybody tell?
May not help to use op amp.
No, that is fine, but how does that benefit? What will be dominating?
Quotient power will be dominating.
Forget about quotient power. Tell me more from dynamic point of view. Load transient, your transient response, speed, everything. How?
Like,
instantaneous, huh? it's non-synchronous. So the first thing, it's non-synchronous. Okay, so you don't have a PWM clock delay. That's the one thing, and we already saw that. Where you actually apply the load, it may make a big difference in your transient response because of the sampling delay. Okay, so and then once you compensate, you are limiting the bandwidth to 1/10 of your switching frequency. So there are two things which is limiting your transient response. One is your bandwidth, other is your delay in the PWM modulator. So PWM modulator is gone here. So that delay is completely removed. Now the comparator can react instantaneously. So there is no bandwidth limitation as such. Okay. So bandwidth is not limited as comparator can respond to any change in Vout instantaneously. Okay, so this is one thing. No PWM modulator delay. And if you remember, what was that? TD equal to 1 minus D into TSW or D into TSW, two cases for trailing edge and leading edge. Okay, so why don't we use this? Why do we care about compensation, all those make circuits so complicated? Just use a comparator in the feedback and you are done.
It's operating variable frequency.
Okay, any other? Let's say I don't worry about the frequency. Resolution, why resolution? If output is always limited between plus delta and minus delta, so average will remain at VREF. No, I told you that I don't worry about the. Okay, so let's see. We need to draw something here. So what is the profile of inductor current? This, okay, and if this is my average current, this is I load. So what will be the profile of output voltage? Parabolic, and where will be the peak of that? Where will be the peak? So valley will be here. Okay. See. Negative charge. You have positive charge here. So during this time, capacitor is C out is discharging, and during this time C out is charging, correct. So the moment it hits the valley, it has to charge. So which means your valley has to occur here and peak has to occur here. correct? So your shape will be, let me draw this color, okay? And if you integrate, you will get the same thing actually. Okay. Now, how much is this? The peak to peak in time difference. So the peak, how much? T of by 2 is, but this whole thing is Ts by 2, Tsw by 2, Tsw by 4, which is 90 degree. And it is quite obvious, you have a capacitor. So the current, when it is dumped into the capacitor, what would happen? You are integrating it, so it will create a minus 90 degree phase shift, okay. So 90 degree phase shifted. So now what this comparator will do? You are asking comparator that if V out goes above V rep plus V h by 2, whatever the delta is, output will go to 0, and if it goes less than V ref minus V h by 2, delta V h by 2, it will go to high. So now my output is going here, let us say this is V h, V ref plus V h by 2, correct? And when I say, my comparator says, okay, you go to change the state of the output, what would happen? It will try to change right away, correct? Which means, or you can say that comparator will take the decision after your duty cycle changes, correct? Because if you look at the duty cycle point here, when you set or reset, let me draw the PWM, then it will be more clear. So during this time, so this was 0, it goes 1 here, draw a little bit lower, so look at the current, so inductor current is rising from here, so your PWM will be high. And it will remain high until this point, correct? Then it will go to 0, then low, high, this is V of PW, okay? So now, let us say this is your crossing point, hysteretic window. You tripped here, but your output is still rising, which means you are not able to bound the output between plus minus delta V h by 2, Okay, so it will always cross. The reason is, I mean, you can see your inductor will keep charging the output. When you reset the DUTY cycle, just look at this triangle, these two triangles. If I reset here, or sorry, reset here at this point, then unless your charge or the current goes below I load, output will keep on charging. Okay, so which means there is an extra charge which is dumped into the cap, and that is coming only because of this 90 degree phase shift. So what I want actually, I want this output to be in phase with current. So V out is not bounded between Vref plus minus delta Vh by 2 due to this makes it unstable. When output is not bounded, then it can go anywhere. So output can even build up and become large. So it's uncontrolled. So in order to stabilize the output, we want V out in phase with IL.